chapter number 3 part 2 okay for class 6 that is 5 to 5 clear so here we will we had already studied in previous lecture about cotton what is fabric what is yarn and etc okay so now we will learn about the jute as we know that jute is also a natural fiber so how we obtain the jute Jute is a fiber which we consider as a natural fiber and it is obtained from the jute plant okay and from the whole jute plant stem is the main part of this jute plant which is being used for the manufacture of jute yes students so how it is been processed basically jute plant is been cultivated and afterwards when this plant is been grown fully it is been cultivated and afterwards this stem are been allowed to dry and afterwards in this stem which is been dried is been kept in a water for so many days so what happened this stem gets rotten and afterwards the outer covering or stem can be removed and it has been used for various types of purposes in our daily life okay next is yarn we have already learned that the term fiber is what thread okay so when this fiber or thread is weaved spun by various processes by spinning by knitting and weaving we call it as what yarn means when the thread the long thread are being interlocked into fiber and which is been suitable for use in production of that textile means for the production of the clothes understood so in Hindi we call yarn as a sut understood in normally we see that many ladies they are preparing something any sweaters mufflers anything so when they are making their sweaters and all that they are using what they are using the thread understood they are using the thread but that thread is not in open they are being what interlocked with each other so that interlocking of the thread is known as the yarn so for example I have a pencil here if I have the thread okay or I have the fiber if I am putting that in a coiled manner like here in this that we will say as what yarn understood okay next term that I'm going to explain you that is the spinning just now we have learned that what is yarn yarn means when the thread is being kept in a coiled manner understood so that is done by the various processes like by chakli or by charkha means whatever the yarn we have that we convert into what fiber understood so the process of making yarn from fiber is called as spinning means whatever the thread we have that we are keeping in the form of coil means long continuous coil of fiber or thread is called as what spinning understood and this is done basically by chakli it is a device understood and by the charkha clear students next is as we have already studied that how the yarn process is been done okay so as we have already the bundles of fiber so how it can be used to make the cloths or how it can be used to make the fabric so there are two processes which are been basically used for making the fabric means cloths understood means from the bundles or the coil of thread or fiber how it is been used to make the fabric or cloth clear so there are two main processes are been used mainly first process that is the weaving understood so in weaving there are two sets of yarn are been used that means two sets of coiled yarn will be used connected in the cross by cross way. Means they are being processed in different way. For example, here some yarn will be done like this. Then some yarn will be arranged like this. Means from up, top to bottom and from left to right. Like this manner. If this yarn is being processed, this process is called as a weaving. You need to keep in your mind that two sets of yarn are being used here, and this weaving process is being done by the process of loom. Okay, so loom is what? It is a device which is used mainly for weaving. Weaving means what? We have already are using two sets of yarn to make the fibers. मतलब हमें जब कपड़े बनाना हो और उसमें हमने दो सेट्स धागे की यूज की है जिसको हम बोल रहे हैं यार्न, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वीविंग. क्लियर? एंड दिस वीविंग प्रोसेस इज डन बाय यूजिंग द डिवाइस व्हिच वी कॉल्ड एज द लूम. क्लियर? एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स द सेकंड मेथड दैट वी यूज फॉर मेकिंग द फैब्रिक फ्रॉम द यार्न, दैट इज निटिंग. ओके, निटिंग हियर वी आर यूजिंग अ सिंगल यार्न. मींस we are using only one set of yarn to make the fabric. Understood? A single yarn is used to make a piece of paper. Clear? Okay, so I hope that weaving process and knitting process is being understood by you. Okay, so we have already studied how the processing of the yarn to fabric is being done, what is yarn, what is knitting, what is weaving. So here the overall process of processing of yarn to fabric and from fiber to fabric has been shown here. For example, here cotton rolls means we have the bulk of cotton or cotton rolls. Okay, so it is being used for ginning. Ginning is what we obtain what cotton from cotton rolls. Clear? And it has been we obtain already the fiber from this. Then fiber is being spun or it is being converted into yarn. Clear, students? So from fiber the next process is spinning, and through this spinning we convert the fiber into yarn, and this yarn which we obtain already is being processed in two ways, either by knitting where we have used one set of yarn or single yarn, or otherwise we are using the weaving method. And from these two methods, knitting and weaving, we are making the fabric, means cloth. Clear, students? So again I am repeating, first we will have the buttal or the cotton rolls, then we will obtain what? Through the weaving we will remove out the cotton. Clear? And then we will have what now? We will have the thread or fiber. Clear? Then through the fiber, by the process of spinning, we will make the yarn. Okay? And through the yarn, either by using any of this method, by knitting or weaving, by both the method, we will make the fabric. Okay? So I think this is clear. Your homework will be define the following. You have to write down the following terms, and this you have to write down on your note. And in previous video also, whatever homework I told you, please do write on your science note. Okay. First term, that is the spinning. Second is fabric. Third is knitting. Then weaving. Then yarn. Clear? The next question of the second is write difference between natural and synthetic fiber. So all these homework please do on your science note. Clear, students?
Okay, so we have learned in this chapter how the fabric is been made. First, if you look at the figure 3.1, the cloth are been kept here. Okay, just come to on page number 19. There splitting the yarn into thin strands means what is this? This thread is nothing but it is a fiber. Understood, students? Okay. Then afterwards, in this page number only, it is explained the different types of fiber. What is fiber? Then natural fiber. Then afterwards, on next page number, synthetic fiber, which I have already explained you. Okay. Then how cotton is been obtained from cotton plant. I explained you already. Then this is the figure where it is been shown that how the cotton is been cultivated and how it is been obtained. Clear, students? Then comes to the next process, that is the ginning. What is the ginning? Fibers which are been obtained, or the cotton which is been obtained from the seeds by combing. So this process is called as what? Spinning. Okay. So here you can check the process of spinning, how the cotton is been obtained from the seeds of cotton. Then afterwards, jute. We know that jute is also a fiber which has been obtained from the jute plant. Okay. Then I explained you already what is yarn. Then spinning the cotton yarn. Spinning, you all know that converting that fiber into yarn is the spinning. Okay. Then afterwards I explained you already, and this is done by various ways, like charkha here, it is shown in the figure. Then yarn to fabric means from the yarn, which is the bundle of thread, how the fabric or the cloth are been made. So this is done basically by two ways, weaving. What is the weaving? I explained you already. Then next is weaving with paper strips. So this is the basic process, how they are doing, it has been explained. Then how the knitting is done, it is also explained. Here in knitting we have used only one yarn. Then this is what handloom. Handloom is basically used in which process? In the process of weaving. Understood? Where they are using the two sets of yarn to make fabric. Clear? Then knitting, I explained you already. Here it is shown the process of knitting. Then the history of clothing material. So basically, if we look at the history of the clothing, when the people, they started settling down at a place, then slowly they learn about the fiber, and they, in this manner slowly the advancement in the history of the clothing comes. And after, now we are using the different types of cloths in our day-to-day life. Now I think this chapter is explained to you all and understood as well. So please do all the this exercise of your NCERT textbook, chapter number 3, page number 24. Complete all the question and answers on your notebook. Just check here, true and false do on your text only, fill ups also do on your text only. Okay, don't do these things, only the question and answers. For example, this one question, first do on your note, then 4, 5, 6 do on your science note. And apart from these, the question which I have given you as a homework, that everything you need to write on your science note. Okay, students, thank you.